proud to pay homage to some of our military heroes. Honorees come in different shapes and sizes. No matter what they all have in common, no matter what the circumstances they're presented with, our brave servicemen and women distinguish themselves conspicuously by demonstrating gallantry and intrepidity while putting their own lives at risk of great danger and even death. Without hesitance, they heroically respond. It's called Above and Beyond. The Call of Duty.
Freedom has never been free. Tonight, we give you a family of heroes, one that believes in service, and they have served us indeed. I want you to imagine that you're 6 years old, friends. You look at a handsome man in a military uniform, and you say, "When I grow up, I'm going to be a U.S. Marine." That's exactly what this man did. After seeing his uncle dressed and decorated, he joined the Marine Corps. He served two tours in Vietnam. He served with honor. 100% disabled from his time during war, but he would do it all again. Ladies and gentlemen, from Houston, Texas, Vietnam veteran Rick Lefebvre. The next hero admired his uncle and his great uncle. He wanted to say he would always be faithful. He served his country during Desert Storm. The U.S. Marine was wounded in battle, but when he left the Middle East, he left his mark. From Charlotte, North Carolina, say hello to Aaron Harper. You know, it's a rare breed. It's a rare breed that's willing to lay down his life so a stranger can live. These two men, their inspiration, well, it stands between them here tonight. He's a true American, and he's an American hero. We tell you the story. He gave his country 8 years of service in World War II and Korea. The man from Roy, Utah, was born in the spring of 1927. He's 95 years old. In the history of the U.S. Marine Corps, there have been three epic conflicts. The Battle of Belleau, Iwo Jima, and the Chosin Reservoir in the Chosin Valley of Korea. This man was there. Third Battalion, 5th Marines, at war with tyranny and communism, fighting in the freezing temperatures, 50 below zero with the wind chill. He's a superior marksman. He was gifted in hand-to-hand combat. Once witnessed stopping three Chinese soldiers single-handedly with his K-bar knife, and he'd already carried one gunshot. One U.S. Marine division was surrounded by 11 divisions of Chinese and communists. The odds, Las Vegas was 15 to 1. His company was 320 men strong, and when the smoke cleared, we won. But only 8 men were left to fight. 8 out of 320, and that man standing here this evening is one of those 8 men who survived. He fought in the daylight. He cared for the wounded at night. This warrior is wearing the exact same uniform he wore in 1952, over 70 years ago. On that uniform is 2 presidential citations, 3 Purple Hearts for being wounded in battle, and as fate would have it, friends, that third Purple Heart was awarded to him December the 2nd, 1952, 72 years ago tonight. He is a hero. I asked him earlier. I said, tell us, at 95 years of age, do you still like pretty girls and fried chicken? He looked at me, he winked his eye, and he said, I can do without the fried chicken. He's been married to Miss Donna for 76 years. He told me he would still climb a tree to kiss his wife. He is a special soul. He is a warrior. He never looked down. He never looked back. He never let go. And that is how heroes are made. Honor him. 95 years old, U.S. Marine Corps Sergeant retired, John C. Cole.